driveway theater project. We do take donations for the project. That's how we pay our actors. That's how we pay for equipment, for process equipment, obviously. But we normally use for these. And also, if you want to host one, these are completely free. If you want to do one of these, we have a nice, we have a sweet little menu. We've got Maltese Falcon, it's a radio play. We've got some scenes from Shakespeare. We're currently bringing complete works of Shakespeare back up, which was what we used to test the failure last year, and it went over like gangbusters. Incredibly boisterous and funny. We also have Blacademics. We are working on some education stuff with a conversation between Frederick Douglass and Captain John Brown, and we've got check leaves, and then there's always something in the works. So if you're curious about this whole driveway theater project, please come see me after the show. I'd love talking about it, so now I'm going to get off the stage.
Enjoy the show, and we hope you think about it after as well.
I got lost. then after a while, it just said, Negro, what in the hell are you doing out here? You ain't got no business being out here. Be all over the middle of nowhere. I thought, the hills have eyes, or that somebody was gonna pop out somewhere.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you're here now, okay?
You are here now. And this is Georgia.
How about a seat?
What?
From my hand.
From your hand.
Oh, it's a delicious medley of seeds.
They are really good.
Oh, no, thank you. I don't want to. It's just
try one.
It's from your hand.
Oh, not to worry. The chef makes sure that I wash my hands thoroughly in a brine of sea salt and lemon juice, rice filtered water, and lavender oil. My hands are the cleanest thing in here.
Act like you've been somewhere. Just one.
Trust me, I don't want more than you. I mean, yeah, it's a little salty, but
I'll get your table.
This is it?
Yeah.
Are they even open?
Of course, and they have been expecting us. I didn't have to call ahead or anything. They're just.
Is this one of those type of places where the gimmick is to be rude to you on purpose?
That's just stunt convention.
Mm-hmm. Yes, they are breaking with the traditional conventions of the restaurant is the place where one makes demands, but rather a venue for an entire experience.
An experience that asks the diner to just let go and be taken on a journey.
But there is food coming at some point, right? Because I didn't drive all the way out here just to start.
Good evening, ladies. My name is Georgia, We do a prefix menu here, so you don't worry about a thing. Just let us do the driving, okay?
Well, I have a food restriction.
No.
No. My nutritionist has me on a
hill. Trust me, I can come back.
No.
Not have to come back. My friend Rochelle here is going to be a good guest and trust the host, right?
Please?
Fine. I was
great.
Let this happen, Rochelle.
Okay.
You cannot be so resistant.
Something, huh? We're within 7 or 8 miles of one another, but had to drive all the way out of town to finally sit down together.
Yeah.
Haven't seen you in a while.
Oh, it's been a minute.
Keith's party.
Oh, I wasn't invited to Keith's party.
I saw you there.
Was it me?
Risha, we the only 2 black women over 21 within a 150-mile radius of this area. I know I saw you at Keith's party.
I don't know, maybe.
Yeah, it has been a while.
It has been a busy time.
Woo!
I am pointing out, I just want to see. And shoes, 4 packs. Get enough of that bottleneck guitar song to freedom!
How can I really taste the indignity of being denied at the lunch counter? Thrown out of bed. Feet underneath body.
my travels, my life living. My brother lived his identity through something different than me. Cash! Danger! The street! Living! Life. I would go to the Kentucky Derby. I liked learning where the salad fork goes now. My brother was learning from the drugsters. In my new book, I chronicle my brother's rise and fall. In my book, I am examining how to give a brother, a sister, a privilege. How we could end up so, you know, how did I do?
A little bland, some rhymes might have helped.
Wait, you like rhymes?
Kings and queens self-hating because they ain't got no meat.
Dying.
Hold up, hold up, I got properly, the English she would speak. So they called her white girl like every week. She studied the history of her mothers and aunts. Rejected her father's faults. She lectured. She fought. But she hit a ceiling. The university said we not feeling.
You.
She was like, Bam!
That was kind of whack.
Stop hating.
Awesome job, Michelle.
This was supposed to be my day, my special day, my liberation day. And she keeps waiting. It's not fair. I did what I was supposed to do. It's not fair. It's no fair.
I'm sorry. You shouldn't apologize. You got a point, which means the main course is all yours, and only yours. Now, let me go pick me up.
My nutritionist is gonna kill me.
You enjoy every bite. You earned it, and
we're in this together. Track to hell.
right? It's a good story.
Yes, he'll probably make a movie out of it like he did with that Anton Fisher.
Right, but I think it was Antoine, though.
It wasn't Anton?
No.
But you feel like you're exploitationing your brother.
Kind of. Yes. I am wrestling with
you. You know what I wrestle with?
You wrestle with boredom.
Yes, you wrestle with aging.
Yes. With single fantasy.
Yes. With loneliness.
With identity politics.
With stress.
With loneliness. What a bomb.
Only means a bomb?
Yes. And if it means nothing, what does it mean?
You wrestle with guilt.
I wrestle with legacy.
No way. Oh, I have been swamped.
Girl, me too.
State universities don't play when it comes to that workload.
Oh, now liberal arts colleges are no joke either.
Well.
What?
They work me. They do.
Well, yeah, but you got all sorts of latitude. Low class size, plus your students are kind of masochists when it comes to homework. I gotta practically bribe mine.
Let's not go comparing.
Was I comparing?
Yes, you just did. You just compared our students.
I didn't realize I was doing that.
We both work hard.
Girl, I know. I wasn't... All good.
I know.
I still don't.
Oh, I don't care!
I am glad that you could join me here. And I'm sorry that we couldn't drive together. I had to rush from campus and run a couple of errands.
Okay.
Well, I just want you to know it means so much to me that you could be here tonight. Because I wanted you to be the first to know that I got tenure!
What? You heard me! I got tenure. Me! No more stressing, no nothing. I got tenure, not I'm supposed to got tenure.
Wow, yeah. Suppose some congratulations are in order.
They are!
You know, I could really use a glass of water. Congratulations, you're on the track.
On the strip, more like tenure ho strong, you could say.
The tenure ho stroke, so to speak.
Well, you know, I am thrilled about it, right? Oh, I was starting to get to that place, right? I was walking around, I was singing that old Clash song.
Should I stay or should I go?
Still no seats for that child girl.
She'll be around,
so you say.
Oh, hey, how's your book?
Oh, that's the other thing I wanted to tell you. I had a breakthrough. Now you know how for the longest time I've been going back and forth about what to commit myself to as far as a manuscript.
Then it hit me. My book, it is an intrepid look.
Have they put that in writing? Your book.
Well, of course. I mean, not yet, but they certainly will. I expect.
Because you know I've heard stories about scholars enticed by the book deal. They dangle the book deal in front of you and then no book.
Did you actually hear stories about that, or are you just saying?
Ibrahim Dale wrote an entire brilliant manuscript about his first generation blackness. They dangled the book deal and said that if, and only if, he changed the book back and made the changes they thought he should make. So he did it. He changed the book. And then, after he made all those changes, you know what happened?
And I bet it was the worst possible scenario, right?
They would publish. Brother spent a year and a half rewriting what had already taken him 5 years to research and write.
Mm-hmm. Well, that is too bad for Ibrahim Dale. But in my book,
I'm sure it is. I'm just saying.
Well, what does this have to do with me specifically?
I'm just saying, don't go drinking the Kool-Aid too fast.
Oh, I don't drink anybody's Kool-Aid.
Right. Or eat their watermelon.
Right. Or eat their chicken.
Right. Maybe grill.
Not grill, not boil, right?
Right. Oh, you know, speaking of Kool-Aid and chicken. girl better come on. That seat was salty and I need some water.
We are crystal clear about how you feel about this. Now back to my book.
Who's blurring the back?
Well, I haven't thought of that yet.
Stop lying.
I just finished the first draft.
Damn, I thought you just came up.
Ooh, my hands were on fire. I was being guided by the ancestors.
Yes, with power, with laughter, with power, humans. Yes, I starving, but
I think I can wait a little longer.
On three. America.
Right. Let me ask you a question.
I get it. Am I a dentist or a black dentist? This is all this hip-hop and capitalism. What I'm trying to say is, the only thing I'm trying to say is that... wait. And by we, I mean black folk of all shades and hair quality. We avoid unpacking this obvious miscegenated moment in which we've arrived.
After room players ball, Barack Obama in the miscegenated soul train line.
Laugh it up.
Is that really all you're trying to say?
And
the New Yorker featured Kareem Peter sound blanket.
You liked it. Good for you. Good for him. Good for his mom. I'm sure she's very proud. Good for your date, but I am not your date. Teaching Ellen.
rhyme.
Yeah? So?
What was that one about again?
So join a troop?
You heard me say he. Stop playing. Come on.
Mm-mm. Carter G. Woodson?
Oh.
You mean the father of Black History Month?
The very same.
Adorable.
Okay. Do you ever engage them in any critical discourse around Black History Month?
What do you mean?
I mean, get them to look past the frivolity of the way in which Black history is ghettoized from the luxury condo that is American history.
No. Because it's elementary school.
Well, I know that, Rochelle. I know. I just happen to think that there is room for progressive innovation.
Well, yes, someday, but right now they just need to at least know the names.
I think, just as an exercise, that you craft a poem. In the voice of Carter G, in that modern pseudo post-racial context, telling the kids, and this is just an idea, that he rejects the notion of a month, and then maybe you can add a joke in there. They gonna give us the shortest cold this month. That's an old Chris Rock joke.
Second of all, Black History Month is in the month of February because February is the month of Frederick Douglass's birthday.
I know that this idea is just.
Well, I just like reading poems about Black people kids. Okay.
All right. Okay. Fine. Show us for the children. I Wu Tang's here.
Yes, I wrote my dissertation on it.
Of course, I remember you mentioned that. How about another poem? Hey!
I think it has been made perfectly clear who the teacher is at this table and who isn't.
Would you just stop your crying?
So rude.
Oh, don't be so sensitive. I liked your poem. I liked your poem. Is that the kind of lazy feedback they pass off as critical insight over there at the liberal arts college?
All right, now slow your roll.
I mean, do you even teach, honestly, or do you just, I don't know, publish and read blogs?
I lead a team of research assistants.
Please.
I coordinate their classrooms, their curriculum,
hey,
their courses.
You there! Yes, you! Pitch me articles on Sunhouse, Black Lightning, and Moms Mainly! And you there, girl, I will require fresh
symbiosis. I give lectures, I publish, I view
you.
You
gently wander the clouds, gently flowing until the muse freshens your sniffer of absence.
Let me go and flag down our server. Perhaps we can order something to stop your crying.
Shut up and eat your salad crumbs. And our server's name is Georgia. Not server, Georgia. So classy.
I don't have the power to be the class.
Oh. That's it. That is getting it.
Wait, where are you going?
Back to my car. Back to the city.
Well, you haven't had anything to eat yet.
No shit.
All right, just relax, okay?
Are you hungry or not?
You are embarrassing me.
So sorry to inconvenience
you. This is my celebration.
You call this a celebration? It looks like some kind of damn MTS bro.
Just slow it.
Are you hungry or not?
I wasn't when I got here, but now I am.
Okay, I am hungry, all right? I am so hungry, it is freaking killing me.
I want to celebrate, right, huh? I want to have a good time, and you are ruining it.
Next time, I'm picking the place. Hey, Georgia, get the hell out of here.
Just stop.
Forget you, Ann. I don't need your help. I can figure things out myself.
What? Finding me, that's it?
Nothing. Figure out what?
Don't worry about it. All right, look, okay, here, just calm down.
Sit down.
Huh? We'll be fed and all will be made.
It's not even about food anymore. It's about you.
Me?
Back to Ohio. Who do you think you are? Talking about some Carter G. Woodson. The man is to be revered.
I wasn't trying to diss him. I was just saying that he knew, all right? Carter G. knew that one day his invention would be a pointless exercise.
I don't think he said that.
Maybe not in those terms, but didn't he say something along the lines of hopefully we won't need to set the pump?
Did you know that some of my freshmen, now these are college kids I'm talking about, they think that the Civil War started with a bus boycott. They think that General E. Lee gave the I Have a Dream speech. So that's why we need it. 1 month is better than no month at all.
I see. That. Right there is what I wrestle with. Better than nothing? How easily we say it.
I will spray this whole cafe with lead.
Oh,
everybody be looking
at me. Oh, you have a reservation?
Break yourself, Bobby.
I have what I
just
it's
be...
It's not.
You know it.
Everything all right? Can I get my own table? Apparently I am out here alone, so I would like to sit alone.
She is just being...
You don't know what I'm being!
Georgia!